We are live in Hollywood at Hollywood and Vine at the W Hotel for the Worldwide Radio Summit 2018, brought to you by A&R Worldwide and AllAccess.com.
What are your feelings about State of Radio today? I mean, you're still in it. You're still in it to win.
I absolutely get goosebumps every morning when I turn that microphone on. I love it, and I'm going to do it until I can't do it anymore. I was lucky and fortunate enough to be in the business when it was an art. The art is to do personality without going overboard. If you work hard and you dream hard, and you keep your focus, you're going to be successful. Your dreams will come true. And I know that sounds like some kind of fairy tale crap, but it really works.
What sets us apart from all of these other mediums? And it's discovery, surprise, companionship, right? You know, 2/3 of the country will still discover music first on the radio.
This, you know, radio is the original social medium. We really were. We're the friend, we're your buddy. We're still curators of music. You know, the power of endorsements, everyone in this room understands that. And when your favorite talent or morning personality introduces you or turns you on to a new song, it's 1,000 times more powerful and resonates much more deeply than finding it anywhere else.
Drake could sing the Toronto phone book to the tune of Happy Birthday. His fan base will stream that out of curiosity and it will go to number one in the UK because his fan base is so huge. So just because it's number one on Spotify doesn't mean it's a good song. It doesn't always mean that.
We have to understand that how we are being consumed and where we are being consumed and the technology in which we are allowing our products to be consumed, if it does not keep up with the young end, we're dead.
Well, we have to make sure that my children and your children also shout at Alexa to give them the great content that you and your teams make. We have to. Because this is vital for the future of the radio industry, getting voice protocol right.
It's great. I think it's a very exciting time for radio, all the new media platforms, the appetite for music is bigger than it's ever been, and we can't have too many reasons to get together and celebrate the vibrancy of radio.
I think it's great. I think getting all these people together from around the world, converging to talk about our business, the content of our business, technology, how this business should move forward, view the future, view technology. It's been a great success. Happy to be part of it.
To bring together some of the world's brightest and best radio minds with some people from the management side and the publishing side, the writing side, the record company side is really great to hear everything going on. Radio is very, very much alive, so Joel and Sat, brilliant move, bring us all together.
Our research shows that this generation is spending 5 hours a day consuming social media. 30% of them are uploading a video of themselves or selfie regularly throughout the day.
Video that you roll where it shows how many screens they're using, and they're using them all at once, they're consuming all this content at the same amount of time. And I think it's a really exciting opportunity in us for content because they're going to consume more content than people are consuming now. But we have to think about that content because it's going to be in shorter forms and shorter bits and such. It's not going to be the longer form stuff that maybe we're doing a lot of today. And we got to think about those different formats relative to that generation and their different habits.
They don't have that connection. And a good example when we talk about content consumption is things went from movies, which were 2 hours, to an email, which might be, you know, a couple of pages, to an IM, which was 140 characters, to Snapchat, which was 8 seconds, and now you can communicate all of that with 3 frames in a GIF.
I want these kids, because it's a very young team, very smart, very young, I want them to want to work here 20 years like we have. And it took me about a month before I realized that's not possible with the generation. They actually look at somebody like me and feel sorry for me because I've been there so long. Like, you poor man. Isn't that awful?
Our research is showing that people in this generation are consuming 3 times as much audio content before 9 a.m. than baby boomers.
So there's more, there's a larger pie for us all to
there is.
All together. Yes. When I get that feeling, I lose myself to the rhythm like truth. And that song is speaking.
you're not playing what they're listening to, then guess what? You are a dinosaur. Another thing that we learned from the students also, we stopped saying new music on the air. Got rid of it. Don't even say it anymore. Because they said, when you say new music, we've been on it for 3 to 6 weeks. And so what we did, we went through all the playlist on Spotify and different playlists and just looked at the language, how they wrote it. Trending now. Release radar. Moving up the charts. Just these little words from your playlist to ours. From your smartphone to us. We start using this type of language on the air, and these same kids picked it up within a week, and they said, you know what, you don't sound old anymore. They told us, we love what you just did. The same kids that were complaining in my office.
I know this sounds like I'm oversimplifying it. This generation is probably the greatest opportunity that our medium has had in a very long time. This generation cares more about community, sense of purpose, and sense of cause than any generation we have seen in many, many years. And this is such a great opportunity that we have to not only program and connect with them, but hiring these young people in because of that sense of purpose. And I think it is a big, big opportunity that we're not taking advantage of.
We're going to develop the next kind of stage of who the next radio stars are going to be. You're going to have to work for it. You're going to have to go out and find these people. When you find them, you're going to have to be, you know, you're going to have to develop them, and you're going to spend time with them and let them make mistakes. And because if you don't, you're not going to find anyone.
Just a taste of what we could have been. What am I feel like? It all comes back to me.
Join us for Worldwide Radio Summit 2019 as part of California Entertainment Week, March 24th through the 29th at Castaway in Burbank for the best in radio, music, media, and tech.